إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أما بعد، فيقول الحق سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, we remind you as always in the day of Jum'ah, in Salat al-Jum'ah, this blessed day, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins and accept our ibadah and our salah. Amen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, إن الله زوى لي الأرض فرأيت مشارقها ومغاربها وإن أمتي سيبلغ ملكها ما زوي لي منها. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he squeezed for him the east and north sides from the earth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him see all the earth. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he saw that he seen the kalimat al-tawheed, the la ilaha illallah, will reach everywhere in this earth, even after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the other hadith, لَيَبْلُغَنَّ هَذَا الْأَمْرِ مَا بَلَغَ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارِ. This amr, this message, this Islam, it will reach everywhere as the day and night will continue till the day of judgment. The topic of today, واقع الأسرة المسلمة في بلاد غير الإسلام. How the Muslim family should live, should educate, should live in the way of the Shara, in the way of the Quran, in the way of the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a non-Muslim land. We seen that the Muslims are unique in their ibadah, in their aqidah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأنما يدعون من دونه هو الباطل وأن الله هو العلي الكبير. Verily, whatever the Muslim live with and Muslim live for is the حق, is the truth, and anything other than the Islam is باطل وأن الله هو العلي الكبير. Also, the Muslims are unique in their ibadah, in their worship. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. Verily, my salah, my ibadah, my nusuk, everything we do is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. as also the Muslims are unique in their shara, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَلِنُوا فِي أَنْفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. So the Muslims are unique in their sharia, because the non-Muslims, the enemy of Islam, will continue attacking the Muslims and Islam until the Muslim will leave the thawb, the dress of this Islam, and take others than Islam. Also, the Muslims are unique in their manners, in their akhlaq. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, we command this ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to establish the justice, the adl, the ihsan, the taqwa, the ta'a of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the Muslims are unique in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Verily, if you love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as you say it, apply that in yourself and follow what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. Also, the Muslims are unique in the Muslim family, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تُنْكَحُ الْمَرْأَةُ لِأَرْبَعَ لِجَمَالِهَا وَلِدِينِهَا وَلِخُلُقِهَا فَانْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَاكَ. If you choose the mother of your kids, the sister is gonna be your wife, make sure, اظْفَرْ, look for the one who has the Islam. And I will give quick example. Two young men, Sibyan, under the age of 15, they didn't reach 15 yet. They went to Abdullah Ahman ibn Awf in one of the battles. And the first one, he came and he whispered to Abdullah Ahman ibn Awf, asking him, Ya Ammi, as respect, because of the age, oh my uncle, where is Aba Jahl? See the aqidah of these two young men. They are young, under the age of 15 as the way came. But see how this aqidah, how this Islam they had in this age. Abdurrahman ibn Awf asking the first one, and why are you looking for Aba Jahl? Then he said, I heard that he cursed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I promised myself I will not live until I see him and kill him, or he will kill me. Then the other one came later on and asked Abdurrahman ibn Awf the same thing, Ya Ammi, how I can look, how I can see Aba Jahl? He asked, why you need Aba Jahl? He said the same thing, he cursed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And nowadays, we as rijal, as men, we seen the Islam, the enemy of the Islam, playing with the Islam. We never said anything. We never did anything, but we take today the example of these two young men, what they did, because they heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they got cursed by Aba Jahl. Later on, Abdurrahman ibn Awf saw Aba Jahl coming in. Then he told him, you see that man, this is what you're looking for. Then as the way came, فَانْطَلَقَا, they ran to him, both, they killed Aba Jahl. Then they ran in the same time, to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Each one of them saying, I killed Abu Jahl. The other one said, no, but it's me. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, show me the sword. The sword you used. Then he seen the blood of Abu Jahl in both swords. Who is this young man? There are two great Sahabi. Mu'adh ibn Amr ibn Jamuh wa Mi'wadh ibn Afra. Both this young man, after they growing, they became one of the greatest Sahaba with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the akhlaq. This is the akhlaq of Muslims. This is the akhlaq of the Quran. Al-akhlaq of Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After saying that, the Muslims, they will see too many things will attack the Islam. And even the public allowed, the Muslim family, if they live in a non-Muslim land. But still, do you think the Muslims who live in the land of Islam, they find everything easy for them to practice the total Islam? Even the Muslims themselves, some of them, they attack the Islam by many ways, media, magazine, news, books, many things, because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that many of the Muslims that will have test, exam after test after test, to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will purify their deen. Qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, Alif Lam Mim. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying, isn't it when the Muslim will say, I believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى, I choose this Islam, this deen as my deen, and I will live and I will die for the Islam, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he will not send the test to see how much you are saying as truth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. And this ibtila reached the Umam before the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's gonna attack the Muslims, the families, the husband, the wife, the kids, in their family, in their house, some from outside. How? The Muslims, they will see things will attack the Muslims and Islam in their houses, in their family. Things from outside, they will come, they will make you feel doubt. You have doubt about the Islam. You're gonna hear this Quran, this Islam used to be only for Jazeera al-Arab, land of Arab, only at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But nowadays, the internet, the technology, the satellites, discovery, all that, this is new time, this is a new technology. We don't need this Islam more, it is something old. Then they will come to at-tazweeb. After you feel that, they will make you lose your aqeedah. Use your shakhsiyah, your characteristic, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a day is gonna come, and of course, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الَّذِي لَا نَتِقْعَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Everything, every single word comes from mouth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's true. Either comes in Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he revealed it to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or in the sunnah, the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Both, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ وَذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعٍ حَتَّى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لسلكتم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم explained How the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Ummah of Quran, the Ummah of Islam. What a shame when we say the Ummah is gonna reach this time after the Quran and Muslims and Islam used to lead this earth. Nowadays, the Indian Islam lead the Muslims, lead the Islam. Muslims cannot do anything until they make sure the enemy of Islam are agree about it. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. A day is gonna come, you will leave this Islam and you're gonna look for things other than Islam to follow. I will not say the Muslim will leave the total Islam before the Islam. No. But his way, his bad, his akhlaq, his mu'amalat, everything related to Islam, you will leave it. But he's still, you're gonna call yourself a Muslim. You're gonna believe in La ilaha illallah. But actions is different. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أما بعد، يقول الحق سبحانه يسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي وما أوتيت من العلم إلا قليلا. الله سبحانه وتعالى الخالق سد وما يسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي. This who came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is ruh? The ruh, the nafs we have, the soul we live with, what is it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Muhammad, say to them, it is something by the willing, by the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no one knows about this ruh, this soul, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the other reminder came to the Bashariya, to the mankind, to the sons of Adam. Even you live with technology today, but still all ilm, all the knowledge you have is very little. But still, we put the all knowledge in one side, but there is something, you leave it, you lose it, you will lose everything. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى فمن اتبع هدايا فلا يضل ولا يشقى. الله سبحانه وتعالى he said whoever take, absorb, follow, apply the guidance of this Islam, he will never lose anything related to the Islam. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Whoever lost or he left the fold of Islam, the ta'alim of Islam, the rule of this Islam, his ma'isha, his life, it will be dumb. It will be hard. He will not be happy anymore because he left the true happiness. The true happiness is the happiness of the Islam, the happiness of the Quran, the happiness of the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made whatever is gonna be halal because of a reason. And whatever is gonna come as haram because of a reason. Not just haram and halal and this thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again, one of the ways that comes from outside to make Muslims lose their characteristic, they call it tahrir al-mar'a. They're looking for the freedom for the woman. You see, Muslims like Allah and knows is a rule, is a hukm by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mother should be in the house, take care in the family, take care in the kids, take care in the husband, live by Islam. But they say, this is something wrong. She should go outside and see the environment, see the society, how it's going. And they start letting the women, the Muslim women, know things not from the Islam, but they make sure they have to follow. This is how the Muslims, if they didn't stick and practice the Islam, the shaytan will attack them. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى إن الشيطان لكم عدوا فاتخذوه عدوا إنما يدعو حزبه حزبه ليكون من أصحاب السعير. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, for sure the shaytan, Iblis, is the enemy of Tawheed, the enemy of La ilaha illallah, the enemy of the Quran, the enemy of anything you practice with La ilaha illallah. فاتخذوه عدوا. Take shaytan, take the Iblis, take the bath of Iblis as enemy. Anything other than Islam, leave it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said, every single word comes in this deen is true. إِنَّمَا يَدْعُوا حِزْبًا. The leaders of shaytan, the junood of this shaytan, they will make sure, they will continue calling the Muslims, the believer, the ummah of Tawheed, so they can be together in Sa'ir, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. This is something. The other part of things will attack the Muslims from ourselves, from inside. One of it, as-suhbah, to have a good company, good friends, good people around you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that in the hadith, as he said, لا تصاحب إلا مؤمنا ولا يأكل طعامك إلا تقيا. Do not be with anyone except a mu'min. Make sure the one you have, the friend you have, the one you know, make sure is mu'min, make sure is taqi. The one you eat with, the one you sit with, make sure is taqi, make sure is mu'min. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said this hadith because he knows how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he advising in Quran that the Muslim should look for the one, for the one who's gonna help you to reach Jannat al-Firdaws al-A'la. After saying that, how we can establish the Muslims on the Islamic way, the Islamic path, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, min ayat, one of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Islam, and ja'ala lakum min anfusikum azwajan, from our nafs we have azwaj, the wives, litaskunu ilayha, you live with, wa ja'ala baynakum mawaddatan wa rahmah, and you have with your family, with your wife, the one you choose. And I said in the beginning, فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ, look for the one who has the deen. Look, the one who didn't marry, the one who look for the marriage. Make sure, choose, not choose anyone. Sometimes our hawa, our feeling, our desires, we just searching one. But it's wrong. You make sure, choose the one who has deen. The one has deen, the one has Quran, the one who knows what is halal and what is haram. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. And you live with love, you live with رحمة. After saying that, we should give another call to the leaders of the house, the father and mother. They should, they must take care of the family based on the Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They don't leave. See, sometimes the father complain, my kids did this, did that. Who you really blaming? You blame yourself. Do not blame your kids. Do not put all mistakes on the kids, on the children. It is you. It is the mother. You guys both who take care of the house. كلكم راعي وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Oh, you believe. Ya mu'mineen. The ummah of tawheed. Qu anfusakum. Qu anfusakum. Save. Protect yourself. That's number one. Faqid al-shay. There's a word. Faqid al-shay la yu'ti. Something you don't have, you cannot give it. Something you don't have, you cannot give it because you don't have. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, qu anfusakum wa ahlikum naran. Oh, you believe with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who you call yourself Muslim, save and protect yourself from the fire, protect your family. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it clear. وَأَهْلِيكُمْ أَهْلِيكُمْ Your ahl, your family. And wallahi, I will say something. If you don't care about the akhirah, you as father and mother, a day you're gonna leave this dunya. And you're gonna leave your kids after you. Are you sure? You're gonna leave them as really true Muslims? Are you sure when Malak al-Mawt will come and you leave them? What are they gonna do? Are you gonna remind them of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Yaqub alayhi salam? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about Yaqub, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصطفى لَكُمُ الدِّينِ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Ibrahim alayhi salam and his sons, Allah said, and Yaqub, he's telling their kids, لا تموتن, do not die unless you are Muslim. Then the following ayah, أن كنتم شهداء إذ حضر يعقوب الموت. يعقوب عليه السلام, in the time of death, he's telling his kids. But actually they're not kids, they are men. They practice, they absorb, they take the whole Islam. إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتِ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ بَنِيهِ His kids, مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي I'm gonna die now. I'm not gonna be there anymore. The house will be empty. The leader of the house will not be there anymore. مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي All set. It's not like today. You have four kids. One of them, mashallah. And the rest, you don't know where is them. One is praying in the masjid. The rest, they don't even pray. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ They say to Yaqub, to the father. But it's not any father. It's not because he's a prophet. Because he practiced the ruling بتعاليم الإسلام. قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ We worship the one used to worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِلَهَ أَبَائِكَ The one your fathers to his worship. Ibrahim as his father, wa Yaqub, wa Ismail, all of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this how the tarbiyah, this how the akhlaq, this how deen work. You make sure you leave, but you leave Islam deen. You will not worry about them. As we see in our daily life, many examples. If the father not dead, you see something, illa ma rahim rabbi. You see things, you cry for it. But what's gonna change? Only you, as a leader of the house, you will be able to change that. If you stick first, you first, on Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because if your son and your daughter didn't see you on Islam, how they can listen to you? Listen to that again. If your son or your daughter didn't see you practice this Islam and you tell them go pray in the masjid, do you think they're gonna listen to you? Wallahi, they will not listen. They're gonna leave you alone. But make sure, look for Iman, look for Deen, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He sent the Hidayah to you, He will send it to your family and to your kids. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase the Iman and Taqwa in our hearts. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit ala al-haq aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ansur al-islam wa al-muslimin wa adhill al-shirk wa al-mushrikin. Allahumma barik lana fi azwajina wa barik lana fi buyutina wa barik lana fi awladina. Allahumma ij'al al-hayata ziyadatan lana min kulli khayr wa ij'al al-mawt rahatan lana min kulli shar. Allahumma ishfi amradana, Allahumma ishfi amradana warham amwatana, warham amwatana. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وأتوب إلى الله.